If you're nervous to sell because you're worried about coming off like a skeezy, pushy creeper, this is the video for you. I'm gonna share my 5 principles to selling in a way that is ethical, authentic, and aligned with your values. It attracts clients without giving off all of those negative, stereotypical vibes that we think of when it comes to sales. If you are a course creator, you sell products, you sell anything online, or your services or your time, this will definitely be relevant for you. And stick around to the end because I'm gonna share you my exact email I sent to somebody who was on the fence who ended up purchasing membership to my course. And if we're just meeting, hello, I'm Gia Goodrich. I'm a content creator and creative strategist. And my favorite thing is to help people connect with their authentic big deal energy and create from that place. And definitely when it comes to sales, we can get out of alignment because there are so many cultural stories that come with it. But the truth is, in order to survive as an entrepreneur or having a side hustle, you have to be able to sell. I just recently launched my course, Magnetic in Virtual Meetings and Video. And so I went through this process of selling and it reminded me that I have come a long way in the 6 years since I started working for myself. I used to have all of this angst and all of these awkward feelings when it came to selling. And I remember as a photographer, the first time I sat down to sell my pictures, I had all these fluttery feelings. I kept stuttering when it came to the price and I really had no idea what was gonna happen. And as you can imagine, it didn't go optimally because I didn't yet know these core principles that I know now. So let's get into it. Price communicates value. When you think about this, this definitely makes sense. I have a pair of shoes that I got for $5. I'm going to treat them differently than a pair of shoes I know are worth $500. Now, a lot of times when it comes to price, we can get our own internal feelings involved about what the value of something is based on our own money stories and the type of finances we've had access to. There's this old adage that I might totally butcher, but it's never sell from your own purse. Meaning that if you're thinking about how much money you have in your bank account, and you're trying to sell something to someone that is way outside of it, you're gonna feel out of whack. And a lot of times those negative feelings we pick up on and it becomes a turnoff. And price attracts different types of shoppers. You can think about a place like Walmart versus Macy's versus insert high-end luxury brand here. The people who go into those spaces have different expectations when it comes to price and value. And when you're thinking about what you're creating, what you're wanting to sell, really remember the type of value you want to offer and make sure the price correlates with that. A lot of times we tend to undersell ourselves because we don't inherently feel valuable and therefore don't feel like what we do and produce has value, and that is a mistake. And just try to be less in your feelings about it. One thing to note is that if you price something on the higher end, you might have people come to you and say,
"That's too expensive."
What they're communicating is their perceived value doesn't match the price, and that doesn't mean that's accurate. That's just for them. For somebody else, it might 100% be the right value price ratio. When it comes to pricing what you do, it should make you a little uncomfortable. If it's an easy duh for you, it probably means you're underselling yourself a little bit. One of my great friends and mentor, Mark, told me this story once about pricing and value that has forever changed my world. He's British and he comes from a family where everybody are millionaires. And he is the lone wolf in that he makes upper middle class income. And he said this to me, "Gia, imagine I have this awesome thing for you. What is that number where for you, you don't even need to see it or think about it, whatever. What's that number for you? Is it 5 cents? Is it $2? What's the number?" And I said, "I don't know, Mark, like $20 maybe?" "Okay, cool. My cousin, that number is $5,000. And he went on to explain that because of his cousin's wealth, for him, that easy number where it's a no-brainer is astronomically high compared to mine. This really anchored in the idea that pricing and value is 100% relative. So make sure that when you are selling something, you're not doing it thinking about your point of view. You want to think about it from the point of view from the person who has the resources to easily say yes if it's a fit for them. Number 2, value is about impact. We're not talking about the hours, the parts, whatever you're putting into it. The value of what you do has to do with the transformation you're giving to that other person. I might buy a course from a creator that only took her 3 days to make, but might have a tremendous impact on my life. A lot of times what we tend to do is equate things based on hours or parts instead of really looking at what is the long-term impact this is going to have on somebody's life. And especially if it's something that's transformational, really communicating that value is important because when we pay up, we pay attention. Number 3, you are not taking, you are giving. So much of the mentality we have when we think about selling is we're taking people's money. Really, we need to reframe that for ourselves and say, no, I am giving them something of value. Sales is like matchmaking, and if the match is right, that person gets to receive something that can benefit them, make them happy, feel better about themselves, give them the transformation they're looking for. A good exercise is to think about something you've purchased in your life. Maybe it was a sweatshirt from a band you absolutely loved. Whatever it is, thinking about how good it felt to have that thing. You didn't have it before, you paid money, now you have it now. Paying for it doesn't diminish the value and how much you love it. In fact, a lot of times it enhances it. That little bit of pain gives you a lot of pleasure when you're thinking about the value of that thing. So it's important to remember that when you are selling somebody something, they are going to receive something from you. And that's a beautiful thing. This is very important. It is only ever about fit. If people say no, it has nothing to do with your offer. It has nothing to do with you. It just has to do with whether or not it's a fit for them in this moment. And I can guarantee you, if you are putting something of value out into the world, there is somebody for whom it's a right fit. Then your job is just trying to find and attract those people. The other thing about this that's important is you want people to say no. You don't want people who are not a fit for your offer. And trust me, from my photography days, I had a few clients that weren't a fit. We pushed through the process, and inevitably what happens is that they're a pain in the ass. They're unsatisfied with the results, and had I seen it earlier, I would have been able to say, I don't think that that match is there. And what I learned as I became more experienced was to actually have a vetting process for my clients, and I would just say right then and there, you know, it doesn't really seem like this is going to be a fit because of X, Y, and Z. How about I refer you to somebody else that their offer is more aligned with what you're interested in? And sure, I'm turning down money, but it is so worth it to have that fit because you want people who take you up on your offer to be satisfied and excited about it. And the last key is, you have to be energetically aligned. Now, what does this mean? A couple years ago, I read this book by Ken Honda called Happy Money. And what's so amazing about it is he talks about energy as in water, as this energetic exchange. When you are giving something and receiving something, there's equity in that value exchange. Therefore, there's this beautiful energetic resonance that feels good and complete. You want to make sure that you are appreciating and welcoming and honoring that energetic exchange. For so many of us, we have so much messed up money stuff that what we end up doing is repelling money all the time. No, 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 I've got it. No, don't pay for that. It's fine. You're my friend. I'll just do it for whatever. And all of these ways that we are repelling money makes it more difficult for us to be energetically in line when it comes to selling. You want to make sure that you are seeking and honoring that energetic value exchange and appreciating money when it comes your way. So when a client pays me, even just to my mind, in my brain, I say thank you. And I take a moment to appreciate that. In doing that, it realigns my energy. But here's the thing, I also do that when I pay for things. I say thank you because I honor the value exchange with money coming in and money coming out. The other part about aligning your energy is when you do, you stop being thirsty and pushy. If you can get yourself in a state where you are happy and honoring and understanding that everything that happens is for the best, you can then have sales conversations that aren't coming from a desperate, sleazy place. That's really just saying, hey, I'm offering this thing. This is the value it could provide. This is how it could transform your life. And whether or not it's a fit, that's up to you. People really respond to this because we don't want to feel pushed into making a decision that we don't want to make. And when we're given the space to really assess things, often we'll say yes, but not for these external levers that are often taught within sales, like scarcity and keeping somebody on the phone until they give you their credit card information. It's not that those techniques don't and can't work, but balancing them with coming from an authentic, ethical place really creates a foundation of trust in your sales conversations. Okay, so are you ready for the email? Now I'm gonna throw the email up here so you can screenshot it if you want to know exactly word for word, but I'm gonna read out the key highlights. The first part of what the client was asking was, which do I pick? But ultimately, how do I make this decision? So this is what I said. In the basic sessions, we'll be focusing on the aesthetic side, so you can make sure that your lighting, tech, and background are all communicating in a way that serves you. Then in addition, we'll be working on charisma and magnetic presence piece, nonverbals, language, to make sure that everything is aligned. With the enhanced sessions, we'll be diving into how to create content that serves your brand, building trust and authority, and grows your audience in an authentic way. So we'll definitely go into strategy on each platform, how to decide which will be the most beneficial, and then how to create content map plan to create consistently. I know the enhanced version would definitely benefit you, but timing is also a factor. And since you are intuitive, I'd suggest what I do, and you might have a more powerful version for this. When I'm at a crossroads, I start free writing my responses to questions like these to myself. What is my resistance trying to tell me? If there's fear, what would be the most fearful outcome? When have I felt this before? If this is the perfect decision for me, what would happen? What would I need to feel like this was the perfect decision for me? I sort of free flow getting inquisitive, and I also try to imagine myself a few months in the future in both scenarios. Do I feel happy, regretful, relieved? And if I still feel stuck, I go for a walk. Just so you know, on my end, there is absolutely zero pressure. If one seems like a fit or neither, that's totally okay. Trust your beautiful gut on this one. I can tell you are very much in touch with it, and it will always lead you to the highest good. Now, you can tell in this conversation, I am honoring the value of what I bring, and I'm also talking her through how to make a decision, not pushing my agenda in any way, but really encouraging her to sort out for herself whether or not it's a fit. Now, she ultimately decided that the enhanced version was a fit for her, which is exciting and amazing because she will be in the course and that's wonderful. But I also would have felt okay if she decided it wasn't a fit, because I know I want my offer to be matched with people who clearly see themselves as a fit for it. If this video is helpful, let me know in the comments. And if you know you're wanting to show up in video, but you're nervous about how you're doing that, check out this video I just made on the 5 monsters that might be sneaking into your language and cutting your charisma points just a tad. Bye.